will be presenting the one, or the 2NC, excuse me, the 2NC argument. As my teammate Randy stated, we agree with the definitions and criteria put forth by the affirmative. However, I want to stress that the affirmative does not answer the question, because all admitted evidence and military failures presented question the military's ability to maintain the our position, rather than, and does not answer the question of whether we are holistically prepared. We are prepared, and where we have issues, we continue to update. I will further prove this in observation three. Please refer to observation three, subpoint one, efficiency. The affirmative has largely focused on quantity and quality, of quantity versus quality. They mention the lack of pilots, for example, and they also mentioned the non-deployable soldiers. However, it is critical that we focus on quality, and the military defines this as lethality. Multi-year plan to build a more lethal force in order to remain the world's preeminent fighting force. Secretary Jim Mattis, Secretary of Defense, Department of Defense, October 2017, access February 28, 2018. Pursuit of global security and stability requires our armed forces to remain the world's preeminent fighting force, and our department has three lines of effort to enable us to remain the world's preeminent fighting force. First, restore military readiness as we build a more lethal force. We will execute a multi-year plan to rapidly rebuild the war fighting readiness of our joint force, filling holes in capacity and lethality while preparing for sustained future investment. This line of effort prioritizes a safe and secure nuclear deterrent, the fielding of a decisive conventional force, and retains irregular warfare as a core competency. Subpoint two, modernization. I want to reemphasize that we are ready, and where we need to address issues, we do have many policies that are recent. Prominent among them is the Bipartisan Budget Act, which raises the national defense cap to 15% for fiscal year 2018 and 2019, more than three times the defense cap increases in the Bipartisan Budget Acts of 2013 and 2015. The Department of Defense on track to rebuild and restore with Bipartisan Budget Act. Dana White, Assistant to the Secretary of Defense for Public Affairs and Pentagon Chief Spokesperson, U.S. Department of Defense Pentagon Briefing. February 2018, access February 22nd, 2018. The adjustments Congress made to the defense caps for fiscal year 18 and 19 in the Bipartisan Budget Act puts the department back on track to rebuild and restore a more agile and lethal force. The bipartisan measure will allow Congress to appropriate DoD funds at the level requested by the President for both fiscal year 18 and 19. Additionally, as I said earlier, where we have inefficiencies, we do have programs that we've just initiated, especially in the years 2017 and 2018. For example, the Department of Defense audit to promote maximum value use of defense spending dollars. David L. Norquist, Undersecretary of Defense and Chief Financial Officer of the Department of Defense, Office of the Undersecretary of Defense, Comptroller News, December 2017, access February 22nd, 2018. We are keenly aware of the sacrifices made by the American people to fund our military. Financial responsibility of America's public policy is critical to our nation's security. The audit ensures we have more accurate data so we can gain maximum value for every taxpayer dollar spent on defense, thereby earning and keeping the trust of Congress and the American people. And finally, we do have a superior military to all the other nations. There is no doubt of U.S. military superiority in any conflict. General John E. Hyten, Air Force Commander of U.S. Strategic Command, Department of Defense News, February 28, 2018, February 28, 2018. Today, we still are the most powerful, dominant military force on the planet, and there is no doubt that in any conflict today, we would be superior in that conflict, Hyten said. But everybody in this room should be worried about 10 years from now. Will we still be at that place? He recommended finding ways to better integrate global capabilities and send missile defense priorities, include improved sensors, kill vehicles, and capabilities.
Time.
I now stand open for cross-examination. You said on 2.1 efficiency, mentioned a multi-year plan. Is it an ongoing process, or is there like a time frame to it?
It is a multi-year process. I don't have the specific time frame, but given that the Bipartisan Act refers to the fiscal year 18 and 19, I assume that it's at least 2 years.
Okay. You also argued that we focus on quality over quantity, right? I mean, quantity over quality. With so many accidents due to short personnel, how do you explain the qualifications of the military if they are undertrained? This is what I have.
Can you repeat
the question? Okay, you argue that we focus on quality over quantity. With so many accidents in the Air Force, in the Navy, in all five branches, how qualified is the U.S. military?
I would harken back to what my teammate Randy said, that I wouldn't attribute the issues holistically to the Navy. We are the top military, aside from top budget spending, we are the top military, and everybody tries to meet our standards.
Okay. And modernization, can you please briefly describe the Bipartisan Budget Act?
The Bipartisan Budget Act is a budget act, is an act that allocates money to all the government agencies, one of which is the Department of Defense.
And how does the, and the last point you said, how does the audit help in the modernization point?
The audit is critical to efficiency and modernization because it looks at the financial statements of the Department of Defense, and it tries to denote where we have inefficiencies so that we can go back and refer to them.
Time.